All right, guys, hope you had a good Christmas and a happy new year. I did, but I didn't get a lot of stuff done. I was relaxing, it was kind of nice. But I did manage to update the characters and camera export, which is working really well. So it exports from Maya and goes into Marmoset. So my workflow would be referencing a character, and now with this new little thing I created a few days ago. Excuse me. I can now load in motion capture. Now ignore the naming on this stuff. It's a little bit crazy. It's just pulling all from directories right now. But I can load in, say, a rifle shot here, motion, and I can just attach it with a quick button push, which is really nice. So I can see what's going on here and use these clips. Oh, I'm just gonna set the timeline to the animation. We'll play that real quick so you can see what's going on. And then if I want to replace it, I can just delete that skeleton and put in, I don't know, maybe a, what do we got here that's interesting? A run? Run aggro. Let's try that one. Just close that. We can just grab one of these controls and any of those joints, and I will hit drive. There we go. So now we have a aggro run. Let's see. That's pretty aggro. All right. So yeah, now I can just export these and bring them in the Marmoset, just like I was doing with the environments, which is pretty cool. I have a couple of shots I'll show you too that I've put together. But for now, I'm just going to show you the next thing I worked on. I chipped at fixing up the environment too over Christmas, so I guess I did get some stuff done. I capped off these back walls, built these weird ice machine looking things, or maybe there's somewhere nice to keep your lawnmower. I don't know. Whatever they are, they just break up the kind of samey shapes of the buildings. Added some pipes, and they're just in there to catch the light underneath these grates. So they're looking pretty good. I do need to add a few more things to the environment. I need some light fixtures, because right now we're just using these cubes, which are actually looking really good in Marmoset, but they just don't look so great here. I also want to add in some hanging chains, some fans, possibly some biohazard tape blowing, you know, like the police tape stuff. So it's like that plastic crappy tape. I don't know. I think it looked kind of cool, maybe tied to some of these little hooks. But yeah, hopefully I'll get on that at some point soon, maybe for next week. I added in a quick camera and dropped a motion capture file on this guy. Made a quick shot. Nothing crazy. I literally dropped the motion on, positioned him, and put two keyframes on a camera. So it doesn't look all that great, but in Marmoset, it gives us an opportunity to see how the export is going to come across. So yeah, the siren in the background. Right. So exported that into Marmoset, which we have right here. Let's give it a second to catch up here. There we go. Now I've got it on half quality right now on the viewport. This run's looking a little bit crazy. I should have picked a better one. But that's pretty much how it looks just coming straight over when I export it and import it. The only things I added were a few lights just to break it up a little bit because it was very dark. So I'll show you what that looks like rendered. Where is it? Number three, there it is, that one there. So if I play this, this is without those lights. It just runs in, which isn't too bad. It's just very dark. And then we have the next one. Come on, what's going on here? And I added those spotlights in manually just to kind of brighten them up a little bit. So this was just a test shot. This isn't actually one of the shots in the piece, but I wanted to see how everything was coming together and show you guys. It's looking pretty good. There are obviously issues with it, but I think it's at the level now where I think I can kind of move on and actually focus on the story elements more and the shots, the camera shots, things like that. Because, yeah, this is looking pretty good. I mean, I don't think it's going to get too much better. Obviously, we're going to add in some grime and those things I was talking about earlier, maybe some biohazard tape. But I think this is pretty much the level it's going to be hitting. And I think I'll be able to do lots of shots quite quickly like this because the import-export process is very straightforward. I would love to have motion blur on this. In Marmoset, it currently doesn't have that, unless I don't know about it. But I couldn't get it to work. I didn't know how to get that working if it is in there. But I'm hoping it does come soon. And I think that will add a lot to it because it's very static. If not, I could render pre-render some velocity passes and just comp it, but it's going to slow me down a little bit. I want to be able to burn through these pretty quick. So we'll see how that goes. I did do another shot here. It's just really quick. It's only a second long. But this one could be one of the shots at the start. I don't know. Maybe. We'll see. But I just kind of threw it together just now, just before I made the video. I wanted to see how it would work. He's just dropping in. Kind of added some camera shake. But yeah. Anyway, that's where it's at right now. Not a huge amount of stuff to show, but it's coming along. And hopefully next week I'll have more actual story elements kind of maybe cut together in a few short sequences. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.